see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Hey folks, that's the late, the great Louis Armstrong. God, I love Louis. Love Louis Armstrong. One of the greatest trumpet players that ever lived. And I picked this song, What a Wonderful World, because we all hope and we pray, whatever your beliefs are, it doesn't matter, for a wonderful world. And today we had that tragic event, terrorism once again, forget about it, in Brussels, senseless murders. It has to stop. It has to stop. And there is good in this world. I know that events like this overshadow the good in this world, but there is good in this world, and there's some good people in this world, and we have to unite, and we have to end this freaking madness. Absolutely end it. Forget about it. Let me give you a little bit more of Louis singing that classic song, What a Wonderful World. Sing it, Louis.
Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Folks, you don't like that. You don't like ice cream. Well, hey, if you forgot who I am, I'm the man with the black fedora today, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Forget about it. Bad Brad Berkowitz. And this is another RSR video email bag show. Now, if you want to get on my next show, and it seems a lot of people do, please, 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 a PSA, public service announcement, stop I Am Immediate Questions. Stop leaving them on Facebook, okay? Because we got to compile them. My assistant compiles them, and then gives them to me, and I answer them. You have to send them in. RingsideReport2014@gmail.com. That's RingsideReport2014@gmail.com. Now, if you want to... What is it? What am I going to say? You know what I'm going to say. If you... Oh, subliminal message. If you want to sponsor or you want to advertise, forget about it, on the RSR Video Email Bag Show, send in serious, even Stack said the other day on the phone, he did the commercial for me, send in serious, forget about it, business inquiries to ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Make sure you subscribe to the RSR YouTube channel so you can get all of our great shows. You know what they are? I don't need to keep saying them. But subscribe, our subscribers are up. We want them to keep going up. Again, our first goal was 500. Okay, finally, the book, close up. Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime. Bye. Who's the bye? Me, forget about it. All right, if you want to pick up the book, go to authorhouse.com. Again, that's authorhouse.com. Now, without further ado, let's slide this book over. Without further ado, slide a little bit more. Let's get into your questions. First question of the night is, Bad Brad, you and Bella make a great team, and for the most part, youngster, you're pretty sharp. For the most part, oh, he might on. If Rigo and Santa Cruz would come about, how would Santa Cruz overcome defeat, or would he defeat Rigo? Thanks, Howard M. from Houston, Texas. All right, Pops, Grandpa Pops, we know you an old cat. Oh, Howard, who's in our Facebook forum, plug, plug, plug. How do I think he would do? Well, first of all, let me break it down like this. Santa Cruz is getting better. Rigo is getting older, and his career is going down because he's going to fight. He doesn't fight. He's got a visa problem. He's got a hangnail. He's got diaper. I don't know, diaper rash. He's got all kinds of issues going on. It's ridiculous. He was a great fighter. I don't know what he's got left. I mean, I'm still saying he's a great fighter. Let's not get that twisted. But these circumstances keep coming up, and they can't help him. They hurt him, and he's not getting younger. I think he's 36 years old. I could be wrong, but he's no spring chicken. If that fight were to happen, okay, Rigo, you know, he's not always the best at taking a punch. He's never been stopped, and he's won all his fights. But however, he's been on the canvas. So, who would I go with in that fight? You know what? A lot of people probably disagree with me, but I'm going with Santa Cruz because I think he's getting better and better. He's more active, and I think that's what's going to hurt Rigo. Could Rigo outbox him? Absolutely. Could be one-sided, and I could be completely wrong. And as we know, when I go on the record picking a fight, bet the house on the other guy. But I do seriously think that Santa Cruz will win. He may stop him, or he may stop him on a cut. Could be something like that. But I'd give Santa Cruz the nod in that fight. And I don't know what's going to happen with Rigo. I think Rigo's going to be one of those didn't completely live up to his potential. And maybe it's some fault of his own. Maybe it's his management's fault. Maybe it's his promoter's fault. I don't know. There's probably blame to go around for enough for everybody. But Santa Cruz by a decision and a tough fight, but he busts Rigo up. Okay? Next question. Bad Brad. I've been watching your shows now since you first started and love how you call it, even if I don't always agree with you. You're honest, respectful, and one funny son of a bitch. Well, thank you. Forget about it, cracks me up, even spelled it right. I saw an article on Ringside Report about Roy Jones, and you went on record he is disgracing boxing. This is one of the times I do agree with you, but even more so, I think the boxing commissions that allow him to fight both here and overseas are really disgracing the sport even more. How do you feel about that? Brian G. from Memphis, Tennessee. Brian G., first of all, thank you for the compliments. And it's okay, folks. You don't always have to agree with me. I don't want you to always agree with me because then you would be sheeple. And I don't like sheeple. What are sheeple? Those are people like sheep that follow the herd. I'm not always right. It's my opinion if I pick something. If it's a factual thing and it's in the record books or I say someone's a two-time champion and you try to argue me it's one but it is factual, then yeah, I am right. But a lot of this is my opinion, and I have no problem with anybody disagreeing with me. I'm going to take it one step further before I go in and answer Brian's question. Same thing on our Facebook forum. You can have an opinion. Today, perfect example. Two Mama Lukes, not one, two. Racial crap. One saying some guy, some schmuck, some Mama Luke, forget about it, says he wishes they take a knife and stick it in Floyd Mayweather, and Floyd Mayweather called him a monkey in his neck. That will never fly. Everybody knows I can't stand Floyd Mayweather as a person. Best of his generation, not a bum. Best of his generation. Person, can't stand him personally. Can't stand him. I'm not going to go in any more of that. I've said it a million times. But you will not call him the N-word. You will not call him a monkey. And I don't care if you're black. You're not going to call white people any racial names. I don't care if you're Mexican. You're not going to call any black people or white people or black people calling white people or any people for that matter. Like Barbra Streisand saying so long ago, people who need people. No racism is allowed. The other Mama Luke called, it wasn't racial, he called Chop Chop Corley, Bum Bum Corley. You're not going to call any fighter a bum in my forum, okay? So I wanted to get that in there because I know a lot of people from the Facebook forum, the Ringside Report Facebook forum, watch the show. Racial shit will get your ass banned. Bye, Felicia. And thank you, Vanessa Quick-Tillis, for giving me that on the border thing. Bye, Felicia. And if you didn't know where it's from, I'm going to tell you. It was Ice Cube as Craig. And Friday, when he told that crackhead, bye, Felicia. Well, you're a crackhead if you frickin' use racial overtones or direct racial stuff towards anybody. I don't care who you are. All of you, man, woman, black, white, green, yellow, polka dot, you're getting banned. Now, Roy Jones Jr., I did say Ringside Reporters went on record. He is disgracing the sport of boxing. But I'm going to also give you your props, Brian from Memphis, Tennessee. You're absolutely right. In fact, you're 1,000% right. As Debbie says, there's no such thing as 1,000%. If I want to say 1,000%, Debbie, it's 1,015%. Forget about it. And I'm about 89% sure that I'm wrong. But I'll take the other 11% that I'm right. Forget about it. Now, seriously, though. The commissions that sanction him here in the States and overseas, they're just as bad. They're disgracing the sport of boxing. You're absolutely right, Brian. Now, everybody says, it was personal with Roy. It's not personal. Do I like his third person bullshit on HBO? This is Roy Jones Jr. No shit, we know it's you, Roy. You're the one with the microphone in your hand calling Max Kellerman. Please, Max, one time, but you're gonna say it one time. Look at him one time and say, I'm not a boy. I'm almost as old as you, Roy. Obviously, you must have forgot. Forget about it. Okay, so Roy Jones is disgraced in the sport of boxing. He's 1 year younger than me, and I don't wanna hear that bullshit about he has every right to fight. Yes, he does have every right to fight, but this fight was billed as a fan, and I don't want to hear that bullshit. He was an MMA fighter. He had four fights. He was pretty bullshit. It was billed as a fan stepping in a ring, and if he knocked Roy Jones Jr. out, he got $100,000. Big freaking deal. Roy knocked him out. It's embarrassing. Roy was a legend, okay? And he'll probably still go into the Hall of Fame, but between this bullshit he's pulling now and the dick pics, yeah, I said it. Look it up for the people that were so shocked when I said it on Facebook, like, what dick pics? He sent dick pics, yes, dick pics. Standing there in the bathroom, it was a big story. We covered it, like so many other sites last year, to a side piece, okay? Who acted like a, whoa, she acted like a, the capital S word. Do I need to say what that stands for? It's an S that ends with a D, and it ain't shit. Look it up. Now, he's embarrassing himself, and he's disgracing the sport of boxing because he's better than that. Doesn't matter how I feel personally about him because it's not personal. Okay? No, I don't like his third person crap, but he's disgracing the sport. And you know what, Brian? You're absolutely right. Any commission that sanctions a fight with Roy Jones Jr. on it, knowing since 2004, Antonio Tarver, Glenn Johnson, Danny Green, Enzo Macaroni, I know it's not his name, but Macarinelli or Macarena, whatever the hell his name is, knocks him out. These are guys that in their, his prime, he would have took him out. Forget about it. You're disgraced in the sport of boxing too, okay? I'm not Roy Jones' keeper. I'm not his brother. I'm not his dad. But you know what? If I was, I would sit him down and say, Roy, you need to freaking retire. You got kids and you want to remember them. You're going to be punch drunk if you're not already having some type of damage. And I'm going to do one better. Folks, you might have forgot this. Do your research. A couple years ago, he came out himself and said he had some type of brain damage. Now, go ahead and tell me I'm slandering his name. One guy said, you're slandering his name. No, I'm not. Because I said he's a disgrace to boxing? I'm not putting false, erroneous information out. It's my opinion, like it's your opinion. But I'm not slandering. That's ridiculous. What are you, the reincarnation of Johnny Cochran? Get the bleep out of here. All right, that's my answer to your question, Brian G. Last question. Bad Brad, to say you are cool, it's not good enough. To say you rule is getting there. To say you're fine as wine and wish when you came into the camera shot, I could see your, oh, I already know who this is. I could see your behind, but I know you're married, so I will leave it at that. Oh, jeez, I know who this is. You know I enjoy teasing you because to be called your favorite Meshuggah, and I know you have many to write in, is an honor. It's been a few since I last wrote in, so I have a few questions for you, my Mr. Forget About It man. One, do you think Andre Ward has any chance of losing to Sullivan Barrera? Two, what do you think of pro fighters being able to compete in the Olympics? And three, my dad want to know what you thought of two-ton Tony Galanto. Hugs and kisses, your blue Jew, Janice, which I already knew, Janice, Bronx, New York. Oi, vey, Meshuggah, Janice, how you doing, darling? Best to your father. All right, I'm going to answer your questions. You want to see my behind. Are you freaking kidding me? That's $50, okay? Sponsor on, tell you what, Janice, buy advertisement on my ass, and then I'll be in a camera shot, and it'll say whatever you want it to say, pretty much. $50 a cheek. Forget about $100. $99.99 special for you, Janice. Yeah, you save a penny if you order now. Call in 1-800-ADVERTISE on the Forget About It man's behind. Operators are standing by. Forget about it. Now, first question. Do you think Andre Ward has a chance of losing? Any fighter on any given night has a chance of losing. I don't think he's going to lose to his opponent, Sullivan, his first name. I think he'll probably wind up taking him out. He needs a good performance. This guy is, you know, I guess they're saying he's okay. I haven't seen him fight, to be honest with you. But the fight everybody wants to see is Ward versus Sergey Kovalev. That's who he needs to fight. That's the super fight pay-per-view. Okay, next question. What do you think of pro? Oh, you know, it's interesting. Pro fighters in the Olympics. I was asked this the other day, and I am. Somebody from Germany hit me up. I'm 100% totally against it. I wasn't for the basketball players. Excuse me. What was it? 92, I think, or whenever it was. Who went to the Olympics? That's for amateurs. Now, you'll have people say, well, they have 300, 400 fights, and some amateurs are better than pros. They're an amateur. And it's bad enough the amateur program from when I was in it from 1883, back then it was the AAU, are losing venues to put on fights. And it's not as popular as it once was. And it's a shame because that's where you got your degree in amateur boxing for the most part. And then you turn pro. I'm totally, totally against it. I don't want to see any pros there. But they'll probably do it because it's not for the, it's more for ratings than it is for anything else. Call it what it is. I don't care what they say. It's for fuzzles. What are they going to say? It's to make the pros better? No. Pro fights make the pros better. Okay? Putting a pro in there against amateurs, it's not right. It's not right. Now, I don't know if they're going to put pros against pros or pros against amateurs. I don't know. Wouldn't surprise me, but I'm 100% against it. And our last question was, your dad wanted to know what I thought of two-ton Tony Galento. Well, as we know, you know when he fought Joe Louis, he knocked Joe Louis down. Tony wasn't a great fighter. He was a bigger personality than he was a fighter. However, with that said, Jimmy Lang is a big fan of two-ton Tony. He was not a bad fighter. He had a lot of power. He was one of those, you know, try to throw one of these wild punches, and if he nailed you, he could knock you out. Funny as all outdoors, I believe he owned a bar. I forget the name of it. Send me a thing on Facebook and tell me what the name of the bar was. Might have been called Tony's or Two Ton Tony's. I don't know. Can't remember. But he was better than your average. No bums in my book. I know they called him part of the Bum of the Month Club. Any man that gets in the ring is a warrior, period. Man or woman, that is. Okay? Okay, fighter. Not great. Bigger personality. Enjoyed him for what he was and on the waterfront alongside Tammy Morelli and Abe Simon, and Tony Galante. What's interesting about those three fighters, they all fought, wait for it, Joe Louis. Can you believe that? They all fought Joe Louis. All right, folks, that's another RSR video email bag show in the can, as we say, and as Frank Sinatra sang so eloquently, so long ago, the best is yet to come. Bad. Brad out.